Hello. Hello, developers and data scientists and fan of Formula. My name is Olivier Terra. I'm working on in the Oracle developer relation teams like a principal data scientist. Red Bull Racing, Honda, and Oracle are bringing data-driven insight to octane-powered Formula One races by pairing data science and machine learning. Oracle is invited you to learn its cloud platform, OCI, using F1 dataset in a non-stress, beginner-friendly environment. Welcome, Shaw. We will show how you can use an open-source machine learning stack and different Oracle cloud platform, ARM, AMD, Intel, GPU, to prototype predictive algorithms for Formula One Insight. Developing machine learning model with Formula One dataset can be used in productions, integrated into Formula One, or reused in video game technology. Our objective is to bring fans and data scientists closer to F1 dataset by running analytics and machine learning model. If you are a Formula One fan and you want to develop machine learning algorithm, come hang out with us to see how it works. I will explain now the developer experience, okay? The Formula One is a really complex technology and the developer could work in different areas. You could see in this design, we could perform the engine, we could perform the DRS, the G-force, the steering angle, we could increase the tires performance for Formula One, or we could perform some models for computer fluid dynamics technology. In our developer community of Oracle, you could access to different public datasets, or you could download them in order to implement your different models. Okay, you can see on the right of this slide, okay, you can see really the different datasets that you can use. I will explain now the experience. Okay, if you are interested to participate in this community, you can access to different hands-on labs like beginner, intermediate, or advanced developer level. Our objective is to build in the future complex models using the advanced infrastructure technology of Oracle Cloud. In different worldwide hackathons, you could compete to develop new fast AI models. And if you are a Formula One fan, you could register in our developer community and propose new insights. If your ID is on hold, we could integrate in the future in other competitions. At the end of this session, I will detail how you can participate to this community. Now, today I would like to explain one of the insights you could test in our beginner console labs. Really, I can predict the next winner for a specific race using machine learning technique. I will explain how you can do this on our platform. If you want to resolve this use case, okay, to detect the next winner, we have defined a developer journey for beginners. The first step is to discover where I can collect the Formula One dataset. In the next step, the developer must build a merge dataset in order to train and test your model. Another task for a data scientist is to explore the dataset in order to train and test the model, and to discover more insight or to detect if you need more data in your dataset. If it is missing some feature in your dataset, and you need to explore this information on the network, okay, to download this dataset. During this hands-on labs for beginners, the developer will execute different machine learning techniques in order to discover the best model and the best predictions. The final task for the developer journey is to see how you publish your model to be consumed by different applications. I will explain now the different states. In data collection phases, a developer can use an open source web interface from Airgast to extract lots of historical datasets from Formula One. You have some limits to consume this API, but for beginners, it's really a good starting point to download quickly different datasets. And you can extract real-time information from Formula One website or from website. For example, to extract the qualifying information because you want to detect the next winner, okay? And it should be fine if you can use the last data set information. Normally, the Formula One competition race is in 3 days, and probably I could predict better on Saturday using the qualifying result than 1 week before the race. It makes sense to use the information and to perform my model, okay? My model probably is better on Saturday if you launch your model on Wednesday. At the end of the data collection step, you have downloaded lots of data sets and the logical data model design proposed by Airgast, okay, has this graphical representation. You can see different tables to store all the information for races, qualifying data, teams, and driver data. In the data preparation step, the data scientist must merge these different data sets in order to analyze which features or attributes are really important in my model. In this hands-on lab, we build a big data set with Formula One features, joining all the data sets downloading in the previous phase. Okay, and you have this data set, this final data set. The typical next phase for a data scientist is the exploratory data analysis, or EDA. The objective is to discover lots of interesting insights in the different data sets. The data scientist can compare the different performance of the three big teams, Red Bull, Ferrari, and Mercedes. And we can use specific Python techniques like Dash or specific explainable library to explain the data. The hands-on lab objective for beginners is to implement different simple models or techniques like linear regressions, neural network, super vector machine, gradient boosting, or random forest, in order to understand how you can use these techniques to resolve the initial problem. You must train and test all the different models in order to discover the best model. I would like to have the best predictions. In other hands-on lab, we will use other new techniques like AutoML or explainable AI to simplify the data scientist work. If you have tested with different machine learning techniques, the objective of this phase is you want to deploy your best training model like a REST API consumption for different applications. In data science, this concept is named feature model serving because you must fill the different features or variables in order to execute the next prediction for the next race. During this hands-on lab, you could see that we have been able to predict the winner for 62% of races. It is not a very high accuracy, and we could use other techniques like LSTM or other neural network, advanced neural networks, in order to perform this accuracy. Okay. The next step of this hands-on lab developer journey is to deploy quickly a web React application to test my model serving interface. You must fill the different features use it by your model, machine learning model. And for example, you could predict the winner should be Verstappen for the next race, or should be Bottas, or should be another driver. We have seen the typical developer journey for a beginner data scientist. Okay. The next step for this Hansel Labs, okay, we can propose different developer Hansel Labs and hackathon. In the different Hansel Labs or hackathon organized by DevRel team from Oracle, the developer could use different Oracle technology, cloud technology, ARM, AMD, Intel, GPU, Raspberry, to implement augmented reality use cases, to develop advanced AI models using Monte Carlo, artificial neural network, or genetic algorithm. You can participate to build Lego Formula One circuit in order to develop autonomous telemetry for Lego circuit, or you can participate to add telemetry functionality to Formula One video games. If you are a fan of Formula One and you are interested to participate in this developer community, don't forget to join our team. We would like to build a big community and develop lots of insight for Red Bull partnerships. Feel free to contact us using the social networks in order to participate to this developer community. You can access our DevRel GitHub repository, it's public repository, and you can deploy automatically the Hansel Lab using free tier resources of Oracle Cloud. Click directly on the button, deploy to Oracle Cloud, and you can execute this Hansel Lab for beginners. In the different events organized by Oracle and Red Bull Racing Honda, you could use some ventures in order to test more technologies. Thank you for this session. I hope you want to join our developer community and to participate in this Formula One challenge.
Oliver, thank you so much for the presentation, man. Really enjoyed that. So talking about how you guys are doing stuff over there at Oracle, when it comes to you've got a bunch of different algorithms that you're testing out, like, how are you handling management of experiments and things like that? Is that something that that you guys do over there? Yeah. Oh, Oliver, you're actually on mute. And by the way, guys, if you guys have questions, go ahead and drop them right there in the chat for Oliver. Right now, the question was all about experimentation management and how you guys are handling that.
Yes. You can use all this machine learning technique, okay, on the different Python libraries, and you can develop your own algorithm if you want, okay, on this Hansel Lab, and you can test all these techniques.
And when it comes to working with Formula One type of data, do you think there are any unique challenges to that type of data set as opposed to any other types of data?
Yes, you can access to all this data set. Okay, it's available. Okay, and you can, if you want to add more data set, you can add more data set. Okay, all these data sets are available to download and to develop your own algorithm if you want. Okay, and in this Hansel Lab, you can see how you can download this information. You can access to the website.
Awesome. And that website, again, that was the GitHub repository that you had that had all the code that you're sharing with us and all that stuff as well. So what's your favorite part about working with Formula One data? Like, what's your favorite part about applying data science to this type of, investigation, if you will?
Yes, it's really interesting, okay, because it's a very huge data, and you can develop different use cases, okay, with different insights with this huge data. And it's really interesting to implement and to test different technology using this data set. For Red Bull, they are interesting to use this type of algorithm implemented by the developer, the open source developer on the network.
Awesome. Well, Oliver, I don't see any questions coming in from the chat. So thank you so much for your time, man. I really appreciate you sharing a wonderful presentation. Hopefully you guys got an opportunity to note down that link to the GitHub. Oh, actually, there's a question coming in here. Are there any specific channels or people you would recommend for learning OCI and Oracle tools?
We have some newsletters. A weekly newsletter, okay, with the news information from OCI to access to OCI. Okay, we have documentation on the website from Oracle. And in Twitter, we publish all the news if you want to access to the all the new technology weekly available on the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure.
And on that same link, are the slides going to be available for this website as well, for this presentation as well?
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, guys, hey, you guys already know what the drill is. Take a screenshot of Oliver and myself. Tag me. Tag Oliver. Use the hashtag DSGO Virtual. Let me know what you enjoyed most about this presentation, guys. I want to see that on every single LinkedIn post. Oh yeah. Oh, actually, there's some questions coming in all about where to access the slides and everything. I think Oliver's already talked about that. There's another question that came in that's, do we have access to the engine performance state data to predict engine failure? Is that something that you guys are making available?
Yeah.
And another question coming in is, with the various data sets available, how do you determine which one you should use?
Yes, we have determined, okay, in this console lab, we explain which algorithm it is the best that you can use, but now we are implemented the rule in Formula One is changing. And in the last week, okay, they have changed the qualifying experience for the drivers, and we need to change the algorithm now. Okay, and you need to perform all the time.
Will Oracle have, free access to their cloud just like they did last year? Is that something that's going to be happening as well?
Yes, you have free access. Okay, you have always free. You have free trials. And to develop this algorithm using the service data science, you have a launcher to access and to use the free tier resources.
Another question here is, what is the best machine learning technique you've recently used for the date for the race?
The LSTM algorithm.
LSTM, yeah.
That's LSTM.
Yes. Well, again, Oliver, thank you so much for coming in and giving us a great talk. Hopefully, you guys got a lot that you took away from that. Make sure you go ahead and tag us both on LinkedIn. Get a nice screenshot. Oliver, do you want to smile for the camera for us, real quick? Get that screenshot, guys. All right. Okay. Oliver, yeah, thank you so much.